This is the Talon 1400, a fully 3D printed fixed-wing UAV. In this video, I will present the full build process for this aircraft and go over all the details. The plane was designed like most of our collection, primarily for low-weight PLA with additions in PETG, PLA or other stiff materials. This is an updated version of a previously available Talon where a range of changes and optimizations were introduced, including a new nose variant designed for FPV gimbals by default. For printing, we use low-weight PLA filament from Colorfab and matte PLA from Isan. Everything was printed on budget Ender 3 V3 printers, which I recently bought and I'm very pleased with the results. Project files are available for purchase on the website linked in the description, where you will find all the details about this design, including the user manual. It also includes information about the plane's geometry, printing tips, recommended orientation for parts on the print bed, and illustrated assembly guide, and a list of required materials and electronics for the build. Alright, let's get into this build. We start with assembling the fuselage and removing the supports. These are already designed into the model, so there is no need to activate them in the slicer. However, the fuselage is available in two variants, with alignment pins, as shown in the video, and the standard version with flat segment joints. The version with alignment pins is available with or without supports, depending on how well your printer handles bridging. Here I have a few supports to remove, and we can move on to gluing. I use thick CA glue for bonding the parts, and at the end you can use an accelerator if needed. Bonding all the fuselage segments doesn't take much time. Then we move on to installing reinforcements, starting with the inner reinforcements inside the fuselage. These are thin PLA or PETG plates that protect the surface where the carbon rods and screws holding the wings to the fuselage are mounted. Externally, we also attach the fuselage root, which further reinforces the wing attachment area directly to the fuselage. Next, we attach the battery pad in the fuselage front section. This file is also available in step format for those who want to customize the hull pattern or add something tailored to the battery. We proceed to the front section of the fuselage, where the nose will be mounted. In the designated slots, I press M3 threaded inserts with the 5mm outer diameter, using a slightly heated soldering iron for this. On the outside, we attach the front reinforcement, a thin plate that reinforces the fuselage connection with the nose and protects the threaded inserts from breaking off. We do the same at the rear of the fuselage, where the motor will be mounted. The firewall goes onto the outside. I printed it with PLA, which works well, but if you're concerned about high motor temperatures, you can use other high temperatures filaments. Now we can move on to assembling the V-tail. Insert 4mm carbon tubes into the slots. After inserting the stabilizers, attach them to the fuselage. Finally, add the V-tail tip at the ends. And moving on to the wings. It's best to slide 6mm tubes through all the wing segments, then glue them together. There's no need to glue the tubes themselves, just push them in. Next, glue M6 screws into the wing root, which will attach the wings to the fuselage. As you can see, the screws are also 3D printed. Finally, attach the wing root, a plate that protects the contact surface with the fuselage and secures the screw mounts. Let's move to the hatches, which were printed in halves and need to be glued together. The hatch locks consist of 3 elements that we assemble together. Then, glue the assembly into the designated spots in the hatches, being careful not to spill glue and block the latch. At this stage, we have the entire fuselage and wings assembled. And now I'm painting the whole structure. I use a cheap grey primer, lightly sanding the surface with a fine grit sandpaper for a nice finish. This step is optional and you can leave the plane in the filament color. With the parts painted, I proceed to mount the control surfaces, starting with the ailerons. I use thin polyester hinges glued with CA, and slots are already designed in the ailerons and wings to fit these hinges with measure 20 by 25 mm. Alternatively, you could buy a larger sheet and cut your own or use other flexible materials, even printing them from TPU, which works really well. To attach them, just slide the aileron a bit and soak the hinges in CA glue, moving the aileron a little to distribute the glue, which will quickly bond the hinge to the plane structure. You can do the same with the rudders on the V-tail. I insert the tail servos into their designated spots. They will be glued in with hot glue for easy removal if needed. Now I temporarily attach the nose to the fuselage. Later I will need to install the camera and the VTX in it. Then I attach the motor by screwing the mount with M3 screws, running the cables through the firewall into the fuselage. I'm using a 2836 motor with a 34mm screw spacing mount, which is standard for similar motors. Another tail variant with an extended mount for the 4108 motor is available if you're interested in larger motors for bigger propellers. This setup includes APC 10 by 5 inch propeller. Returning to the wings, we insert threaded inserts where the servo covers will be attached just as before. In the designated spot on the aileron, we glue the horn. The choice of the horn is flexible. I've listed the ones I used, but you can slightly modify the hole with knife to fit different horns or edit the aileron file. We glue the servo into the designated slots with hot glue. Route the pushrod and attach the servo cover. The cover is available in step format for easy editing, such as adding a screw-mounted servo holder. This eliminates the need for manual positioning and gluing of the servo. Community-made solutions are also available. Join our Facebook group and Discord server for this. Links in the description. Repeat the process with the rudders and connect them to the servos. Now let's look at the nose. Besides the camera, I've already mounted VTXs in two nose variants. The first, printed with low-weight PLA, holds a standard FPV camera from Walksnail with VTX mounted on the upper shelf. Any standard 19x19mm camera and VTX should fit. I've also prepared a nose for the Kadex GM3 FPV gimbal, printed in PLA. It allows free movement while protecting it from below. Noses are easily detachable. Step files are available if you need to modify them for custom cameras, sensors, antennas, or other payloads. Finally, insert the main carbon tubes of 10mm diameter and slide the wings to the fuselage. To secure them, tighten the M6 screws which go into the fuselage using 3D printed knobs, easily accessible through the center hatch. Now you can try fitting a battery and securing it with a zip tie. It can hold a really large pack. I'm starting with the 4S 5 ampere hour LiPo, which should provide about an hour of light time on gentle flights. The aircraft is basically ready. The electronics layout is simple, with the FC in the fuselage center under the middle hatch, GPS with a compass nearby, ESC in the rear, and a receiver attached to the fuselage sidewall. Autopilot on board. I've prepared a simplified wiring diagram if anyone's interested. Additional components like a pitot tube or extra sensors can also be added. What you see here is just a basic setup. Let me know if you would like a video dedicated to the electronics, where I can show cable connections or necessary soldering for beginners. Finally, we test the plane's operation. The gimbal is controlled via PWM using sliders on the transmitter, although it can also be done with head tracking. At this stage, the build is complete and we are ready for the maiden flight. The flight videos are already on the channel, feel free to check out. Let me know in the comments section if you enjoyed the video and if anything you're interested in was missing. See you on the next project!